Time for a new Zammad release. Zammad 6.2 comes with great features and important improvements in general. This is a security update that should be installed as soon as possible. I'm super hyped to show you around. Let's talk about breaking changes first. While some are noted as breaking, they are actually improved behaviors. Up to now, Zammad did not correctly verify SSL certificates. This is finally history. While this is great, it requires your manual attention in every configured functionality that communicates via SSL except Microsoft C65 and Google Mail. Email channels need your adjustment to actually enable the SSL verification. It is not on by default on upgraded systems. Administrators should revisit all channels, integrations and webhook configurations. I tried to cause a rethink on the way this is handled, but failed. Zammad by default replies to emails that are larger than your maximum email size. The reply requests the sender to send a smaller email within the set limit. Up to now, these emails were not imported, but also not discarded. This would cause Zammad hoarding affected emails within vast pool oversized mail without any monitoring incident. With 6.2, oversized emails will be discarded and no longer stored in Zammad's file system. You can safely remove the affected folder after reviewing the mails it may contain. Zammad will still reply to the sender. Should you have group names with double colons, Zammad will rename these to a minus during the upgrade. Also, if you have the objects name underscore last and parent underscore ID within the group scope, these will be renamed with a leading underscore. Values that represent URI values are no longer allowed as first and last name for users. Affected users are not automatically migrated during the upgrade. If you update an affected user later on, it will be sanitized in that process. This is a security-related change. Zammad 6.2 is no longer providing packages for the following systems: SLES 12, CentOS 7, Debian 10 and Ubuntu 18. Should you still use an affected system, please consider upgrading the OS before Zammad or migrate to a new machine. Last but not least, with Zammad 6.3 or later, API access to Zammad's ticket states and priorities is no longer available with the admin object permission. There's no immediate action required yet. Should you use the API to adjust states and priorities, keep this in mind during future releases. I know that was a lot of talking. I will give you a break from my face. Let's take a look at improved visuals in Zammad instead. The group selection was drastically changed. This actually is a big change for instances with many groups to select from. You can now search for groups when clicking into the group selection field. The value will automatically be moved to assist you. You can still scroll down the whole list and see what currently is selected at any time. That's actually not all what happened to groups. From now on, you can use nesting. With this, you can have a depth of up to 6 groups, which should be plenty for organizing. For some of you, this may even deprecate other ticket fields. You also don't have to worry about group references in, let's say, triggers. If you change a reference group to a parent of another group, Zammad will automatically adjust the reference as well. A group with children will also take all its children with it if you change it to another parent or a root group. There's only one thing you have to keep in mind when rearranging all these groups around. If you change existing groups with a lot of tickets, Zammad will have to adjust all affected tickets in the search index. This means that the change can cause a high amount of delayed jobs. Please consider doing this in a maintenance window after your business hours. Another great change affects the group permission within roles. As soon as you select an agent permission, Zammad allows you to configure the agent's group permissions. As you see, this configuration part has been overhauled completely. You can now select only the required groups with their permissions, instead of having this big chunky matrix of groups and their access permissions. This cleans up the role configuration and overview a lot. There are also improvements that should be mentioned. The LDAP integration now supports LDAP interfaces like Okta LDAP that disallow any unauthenticated request. Beside of SSL, you can now use StarTLS in the integration. SAML requests now allow signing and encrypting. This increases security and validity for IDP authentications even more. Rebuilding your search index was always a time-consuming process with big instances. The process would use one thread only, which of course takes time. Now you can add a number in brackets at the end of the rebuild comment. The number resembles the number of threads to spawn. You should not use more than the number of calls your host has. This may have a negative impact when you're doing this during their working hours. Zammad Docker containers now also are available as RIM images. Now let's talk about what you've been definitely waiting for. In many companies, an image of the sending person is used in the signature to give the recipient a more personal feeling. The community has requested this feature a lot in the last years, and the time has finally come. Zammad provides you with all sorts of avatar variables that you can use in text modules, schedulers, triggers, and of course, signatures. You can also define the image size to fit it better to your use case. You can finally add your custom CA certificate to Zammad for SSL verification. This previously was only possible manually on the host system of on-premise installations. Now on Docker and hosted environments, you also have this option. No more going down the console, just simple management within Zammad's UI. Always make sure to verify the source of custom CAs, check their origin to stay safe. A fair warning regarding S3 and certificates. To the moment of writing the script and recording of this video, Zammad would not use the custom CA certificates of Zammad to verify S3 endpoints. This will require you to add your CA certificate to the host system like before for now. Now you guys will love this. Up to now you could only use the scheduler and ticket scope. With Zammad 6.2 this has been extended. From now on you have the scopes ticket, user and organization. This allows you to time events or adjustments if needed. This also has a great effect on the removal of tickets. You can now not just remove tickets, but also users. Tickets can still be removed immediately during the scheduler job run or added as a data privacy deletion task without removing users. For users, you can add a data privacy deletion task only. Right now, organizations are still not part of the removal options via UI. This, however, might come in a feature. Let's hope. 6.2 comes with another reason for you to migrate your MariaDB installation to PostgreSQL. The new external data source field is only supported for PostgreSQL installations. It allows you to query a third-party system like a CRM. Right now, Zammad only supports GET requests and expects JSON responses. For authentication, you can either use token access or HTTP basic authentication. Within the object configuration, you can even test the field function. Please note that this may not work if you use variables in your lookup due to missing scope. This field heavily relies on its internal variable search.term. According to my test, you cannot use any other variables. Again, that's the moment I wrote the script for this video. Now the last feature is weather for advanced users. Zammad finally supports simple storage for its attachments. To use S3, you have two options on how to proceed, either with a configuration file or an environment variable. The latter will be relevant if you're using a Docker-based installation. If you choose to use the environment variable, populate the variable s3_url with an S3 URL. If you prefer the file configuration approach, you'll have to rename the sample storage YAML dist file to storage YAML within opt-zammad-config-zammad. Within this file, you can either configure S3 with attributes or provide a S3 URL. Whatever you decide on, ensure to remove the other method to have consistency. The URL in this file is also the URL you'd want to use with the environment variable. After changing and adjusting the configuration to your needs, restart Zammad. You can also double check your configuration by running store colon colon provider colon colon s3.ping question mark in the Rails console. Restarting Zammad is required upon every S3 configuration change to apply your changes. Now go to Zammad's web UI and enable S3 storage within the configuration. From now on, all new attachments will be written to the S3 storage. If you want to move existing files, use store colon colon file.move db s3 in a Rails console. Replace db with file in case you have your attachments in the file system instead of the database. Your bucket does not require public access. Zammad will fetch all attachments before sending it out to the customer or agents.
If you have watched this video up to this point, I wanted to say thank you. Thank you for supporting me in what I do and your patience. Until next time, take care.